Welcome to our Year 6 showcase.
And this is my pony Twiggy. She's 12 years old, and this is what I can do.
Thank you. Hi, it's Bella B and I'm doing comedy and a few pranks.
So, some people may claim that only gods and goddesses can walk on water. So, here's proof that it's not true. Voila. Prank number one. Alex, you ready to run? And he clearly thought this was full of water. Number two. Prank number two. And that is a wrap.
Well, this is my talent for the school talent show, snake handling. And here is my assistant, Raffles. Raffles is an adult male corn snake. So, for my talent, I'm going to be showing myself interacting with him in various ways. Now, I have had some practice in this because I have touched him before. So if we can just wait for him to get a decent bit away from the tank, and then we can grab the snake. Okay, Raffles, you can... Okay, he's trying to escape. And there we go. Apples. Now, the trick with snakes is not to touch their head or the area around their tail. But you can definitely stroke them. Now, you'll need to wash your hands after touching a snake because they, like most animals, they can contain germs. What's he doing? Why is he moving in short bursts like that? I see it, he wants my arm. Don't bite me. He's not very used to this sort of attention before. Ooh, look. If you're going to feed a snake, make sure you have a feeding tank like the one up there, because otherwise they might swallow any substrate that's in their tank. Doing. So as you can see, he's being very cute. Smile for the camera, Raffles. Now let's try and put him back in his tank. Come on, Raffles. Is that enough? No. Being held for one day. So we can just wait for that tail to go in. then we've done it.
Yeah. You can place it on whatever pile you want, in whatever order.
Okay.
And I want you to do the exact same thing for the very last one.
Okay.
I want you to place it down in any order. Okay. Now, which card do you want? Which pile do you want to go on the bottom?
This one.
Okay. Which on top of that?
That one there.
Now, do you want this one to go on top or bottom?
Top.
Okay. Now, how many times do you want me to split the deck?
Two times.
Okay. One. Two. Okay, now I'm going to put it into two piles. Now, which pile do you want to go on top?
I would like this one. Go on top.
Okay. Now, have you heard of the ancient legends of the magic card gods?
Yes.
I'm going to try and enhance some of that power to make these cards work, okay?
Okay.
First, I'm going to spell out club. C-L-U-B. Now, heart. H-E-A-R-T. And now, diamond. D-I-A-M-O-N-N-D. Now, so you don't think there's any funny business going on, I'm going to do it the other way around.
Okay.
C C-L-U-B, the club, H-E-A-R-T, the heart, and our diamond, D-I-A-M-O-N-D. Now just to speed things up, provider, now would you be impressed? All of them were in the exact same piles which they were at the start. Magique! Hello, and today we are doing some magique with my wonderful assistant, Charlie. So, I have 21 cards here. Pick any card from the deck.
Okay.
Now, put it back on the deck.
Why did you see the card the last
time? Start again. Hello, and we are going to do, and today we are doing some wonderful magique with my amazing assistant, Charlie. So, pick a card, any card. Memorise that card.
Okay.
And put it back in the deck. Now I'm going to split this deck into three piles.
Okay.
And then tell me which pile, at the end of I have done the three piles, which pile your card is in. Which pile was your card in?
Yes.
Okay. Now, two more times.
Okay.
Which pile was your card in?
This one.
One more time. Which pile was your card in?
This one.
Now, the 11th card that I place down will be your card. 1, 2. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11. Was that your card?
Yes!
Magique!
A young man named Dave was a stand-up comedian. His wife Nikki was unfortunately ill with cancer and was in hospital. He told her lots of jokes, he brought her flowers and he sang her songs. Nikki thought it was extremely sweet, but was worried that one day she'd pass and he'd be left alone. The following week, Nikki unfortunately died. It was very sad for Dave and he was extremely upset. He met a nice lady called Elizabeth and she helped him through the pain of losing Nikki. He eventually went back to work, but only 1 week later, he got fired. Devastated, he decided to visit Nikki's grave. Years later, Elizabeth and Dave got married and had a child named Joshua. Joshua was 5 years old when his mother disappeared. It was extremely worrying for Dave as he wondered what was happening to all the people he loved. He was scared that he'd lose Joshua and he kept him close and he didn't let him go to nursery. He didn't let him go anywhere or do anything. Joshua was extremely confused of what happened and was questioning his father why. Eventually, Joshua grew up, he got a job, and he moved away. Dave was extremely lonely, so his father and sister came to live with him. His sister got him a great Dane called Becky. Becky brought such joy to Dave. He loved her so much. He always took her to visit Nikki in the cemetery, and he went to visit Joshua on the weekends. And eventually, Joshua came back to live with Dave because he felt alone. And they were watching comedy films every night, and Joshua stole all the very good snacks.
Oppan Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, 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 op. Oppan Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, 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 op. Oppan Gangnam Style. Wobble baby, wobble baby, wobble baby, wobble. Yeah. Wobble baby, wobble baby, wobble baby, wobble. Yeah. Wobble baby, wobble baby, wobble baby, wobble. Yeah. Wobble baby, wobble baby, wobble baby, wobble. Yeah.
Thank you.